Reading from the book of Genesis. When they heard the sound of the Lord God moving about in the garden at the breezy time of day, the man and his wife hid themselves from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. The Lord God called to Adam and asked him, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, but I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid myself." Then he asked, "Who told you that you were naked? You have eaten then from the tree of which I have forbidden you to eat." The man replied, "The woman whom you put here with me, she gave me the fruit from the tree, and so I ate it." The Lord God then asked the woman, "Why did you do such a thing?" The woman answered, "The serpent tricked me into it, so I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, you shall be banned from all of the animals and from all the wild creatures. On your belly shall you crawl, and dirt shall you eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, between your offspring and hers. He will strike at your head while you strike at his heel." The word of the Lord. Amen.
darkness have seen a great light. Upon those who dwelt in the land of gloom, a light has shone. You have brought them abundant joy and great rejoicing, as they rejoice before you at the harvest, as men make merry when dividing spoils, for the yoke that burdened them, the pole on their shoulder, and the rod of their taskmaker. You have smashed as on the day of Midian, for every boot that trampled in battle, every cloak rolled in blood, will be burned as fuel for flames. For a child is born to us, a son is given us. Upon his shoulder dominion rests. They name him Wonder Counselor, God Hero, Father Forever, Prince of Peace. His dominion is vast and forever peaceful. From David's throne and over his kingdom, which he confines and sustains by judgment and justice, both now and forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
prophet Micah. Thus says the Lord, you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, too small to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me, one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient times. Therefore the Lord will give him up until the time when she who is to give birth has born, and the rest of his brethren shall return to the children of Israel. He shall stand firm and shepherd his flock by the strength of the Lord, in the majestic name of the Lord his God. And they shall remain, for now his greatness shall reach to the ends of the earth. He shall be peace. The word of the Lord.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant in what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow. For the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you, and dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba, shall come bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. After Jesus' birth in Bethlehem of Judea, during the reign of King Herod, astrologers from the east arrived one day in Jerusalem, inquiring, "Where is the newborn king of the Jews? We observed a star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." At this news, King Herod became greatly disturbed, and with him all Jerusalem. Summoning all of the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. In Bethlehem of Judea, they informed him, "Here is what the prophet has written. And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the princes of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel." Herod called the astrologers aside and found out from them the exact time of the star's appearance. Then he sent them to Bethlehem. After having instructed them, "Go and get detailed information about the child. When you have discovered something, report your findings to me, so I may go and offer him homage too." After their audience with the king, they set out. The star, which they had observed at its rising, went ahead of them until it came to a standstill over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, found the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their coffers and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. They received a message in a dream not to return to Herod, so they went back to their own country by another route. The word of the Lord.
O God, who gladden us year by year as we wait in hope for our redemption, grant that just as we joyfully welcome your only begotten Son as our Redeemer, we may also merit to face him confidently when he comes again as our Judge, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please rise.